How's it going, Teal Boys? It's the semifinals. It's us against West Virginia. And on the other side of the bracket, we have Tennessee and Oklahoma, which means there is a chance for the college football national championship to be either all SEC or all Big 12. Or I guess just SEC versus Big 12. But those are the only two conferences still remaining in this playoff. We have to face off again against the number four Mountaineers, 12-1. They won the Big 12, so it is Big 12 champion versus SEC champion on one side of the bracket, and on the other side, it is SEC runner-up versus Big 12 runner-up. So, in my mind, that should be flipped. It should be a champion versus a runner-up on both sides, but we didn't get to choose the seeding, so the committee decided that was what's best. Before we get into this game, I got to apologize. Upload schedule's been all over the place, kind of in the middle of starting a move. So for the next couple weeks, things could either be really consistent or really inconsistent or maybe consistently inconsistent. So please bear with me on that. Once we get settled in, everything should go back to a more consistent upload schedule, especially because we'll have a new dynasty. So everything will be fresh. I'll be super excited to record those. We got nothing to look at, so let's just go straight into this game. West Virginia, the 90 overall team, 5 overall lower than us, with a 93 offense and an 87 defense. So we have the big edge defensively, but both teams should have similarly high-powered offenses. West Virginia, man, I like West Virginia's uniforms. I don't know what it is about them. Their true blue is really solid. It's kind of like Cal, but like further east. But I tend to like the Mountaineers a little bit more. We could give these guys a lot of options. I'm honestly thinking that maybe we do some sort of colorway. I wouldn't be against going true blue against just straight up teal boys. So I think maybe that's what we're going to do. We could go home uniforms, but I like the true blue. And we're going to make this incredibly confusing by wearing the all teal. I might have to restart this game if it's too confusing, because that's a lot of blue on the field at once. But let's give it a shot. Let's see if we can make it into the national championship game. Coming into this one, West Virginia with their 93 overall offense looks pretty mediocre, definitely top 25 in the country. They don't put up a whole lot of yards, but they get a lot of points, which to me means they either do it special teams or their defense has done a pretty solid job this season. And looking at their defensive ratings, that seems like it could be the case. Sixth in points allowed, fifth in yards allowed, and then top 15 in passing and rushing yards allowed. Meanwhile, our offense scores a ton, but really it's because of our special teams. We don't put up a crazy amount of yards. We've been passing the ball well this season. We'll hope that that can continue. Again, they've got a good defense. Defensively, we give up a few more points per game, but hold opponents to about the same amount of yards, although our rush defense is absolutely killer. So kind of hoping that they try to run the ball quite a bit today and we can just shut them down. Top players for us, again, this is for next season, I'm fairly certain, but 97 overall. Radon, we got a 94 and a 92 for them. 92, 91, 91. So next season, they should be a little bit worse than us still. Kind of feels like that. No injuries today, so it's going to just be a battle to see who is truly the better team. It is a clear, well, maybe a little bit foggy New Year's night here at Hard Rock Stadium. I imagine we're into January now. See what we can do in this Orange Bowl as they go with tails on the coin toss and lose. So we're going to be able to kick this ball off to start the game. With just a couple of miles an hour of wind at Frederick's back, he's got this Orange Bowl kicked off. It's going to be a fieldable kick for West Virginia, and the Mountaineers get a decent return, almost to the 20. That's good for us. I gotta say, the teal versus the blue is interesting. Hopefully we should be able to distinguish who's who. They're going to run on first down, and Will Phillips is there for the stop just past the line of scrimmage. Going to go into the cover two for a play, expecting the pass. No, they're going to run it. Space for the running back, and he's taking off. He ran into a blocker. He could have had a whole lot more, but Darren Alexander gets them almost to midfield. So West Virginia coming out and running right out our defense out of the gates here. It looks like it's going to be another one. Jenkins is there on the blitz, and we get into the backfield and stop him for a loss. I'm expecting a pass to show up eventually, but they're just keep bamboozling with me. The drop play works pretty well. We got him in a third down, but only 4 yards for the Mountaineers to go. I'm not sure with all the news in the real world about the Big 12, I'm not sure how long the conference will stick around in our dynasty. So this playoff could be maybe a last hurrah for the conference with Oklahoma and West Virginia trying to make it to the championship together. Mountaineers need a little bit more, though. We get the stop on third down. We'll force them to punt this one away near midfield. I'm going to try to return this with Marquise Jackson. He holds on to the punt, and he's got a little bit of space, and he got a couple yards for us. So they started their drive at the 19. It looks like that's exactly what we're doing as well. Handing this one off on the counter on first down to Mike Fontaine. He's got a lot of space, and he's got 9 yards. Both offenses with a couple of big runs early on, but we're going to go to the air first as we'll see if we can burn them where we get most of our yards outside the pocket. This one, patience, not quite paying off. Almost had Malcolm Williams there, but couldn't quite get it to his hands. Third and inches. We definitely don't want to have to punt this ball away, so we will run it. Safety coming on the blitz, but it's not going to matter. Fontaine has enough space on the edge just to get across that line. We will look to the air again. Got to complete a pass eventually. They're bringing a lot of pressure. Maybe over the middle. J.J. Barr holds on to that one. That's a tough throw to make. But the fullback comes down with it. They have a guy out for the game with an ab strain. So that could be completely game-changing for us as we're going to run it on second and two. Mike Fontaine going up the middle on the fake fly. All right, let's try something. We don't go with the triple option very often. We'll bring Chad Bradshaw in motion and see what he can bring to us on this one. Outside the pocket, the pitch is off. Bradshaw makes a man miss, completely stunned him, and Chad Bradshaw's off to the races. He's first one into the end zone today. And the Teal boys taking a 7-0 lead, a big play call, a big pitch as Radon is getting hit on that one. And just some great running from the wide receiver to find the space and find his way into the end zone. So we take the early lead. We do get the ball to start the third quarter, so we're already in the driver's seat of this game, hoping it stays there. And oh my gosh, we forced the fumble. It's a shame we couldn't recover it, but West Virginia's gonna have terrible field position to start this drive. They'll take over from the 8-yard line. So inside their own 10, we're gonna bring the blitz. It's a draw. Can we get there? It is a loss of 3. Backing him up ever closer to that end zone. I'm going to get really aggressive here. I'd like to use Wilson, try to get some pressure on this quarterback. I was expecting a pass for some reason, and that was a mistake. Well, we just gave up pretty much everything. 3rd and 2. Let's go back to the blitz and hope that they do run the ball once again. Trying to bring that pressure. Quarterback feeling some pressure. Gets hit in the backfield, escapes, but then finally gets pulled down. It's 4th and 2. They're going to have to punt the ball away again. Don Riley with a big sack. A lot of pressure on that play. A lot of pressure on the drive. And the defense ends up getting the job done. So West Virginia not going to fake this punt. And it will be a returnable kick. We should start with this ball inside West Virginia territory. Nope, I backed this up because I was trying to get to the edge. Still great field position. I'll try to make this a 2-score lead. Just going to go to the air on first down, looking for the running back. No, we're going to throw the timing route. Marquise makes a man miss. Got a couple extra yards because of that, and he breaks his school record for receiving yards in a season there. It was his own record that he broke from last year, but just increasing it, making it that much more difficult for somebody else to come in. The Williams on the right, we're going to look for him through the air, and I should have thrown it to Malcolm. That was a mistake. Expected the corner to go with the deep route, so I threw to the short little check down, and that didn't work out because he went out of bounds. 2nd and 10. Run the read option. Radon can get us some positive yards and get us a more manageable 3rd down. Here in the semifinals of the playoffs, if we don't convert this, we are going to kick the field goal. Got to take the points when they're available to us. But Mike Fontaine gets some great blocking on the counter. Gets us a new set of downs to work with. I'm absolutely expecting a touchdown here. Mike comes in motion. on the play action will try to get outside the pocket, just evading the defender, and we have Williams in the end zone. How did Malcolm catch that one? Kind of went for a semi-dive and then got hit immediately, but he holds on through the contact, and it's a two-score lead now for us. So far, Teal Boys are winning this battle of the blue. Let's see if it can continue. 26 seconds left in the first quarter. Hope for the best as they get their best return of the day. Still not down. My goodness. He was fighting for every yard there. Well, let's see what we can do. First down, again, bringing the pressure. These guys have really only run the ball so far in this game. It looks like they will step back to throw. And, well, I was out of position, but my man wasn't even the one that caught it. Luke Jolly comes down with it and gets the first down. A quick play, trying to utilize every second here, I guess, of the Mountaineers is, well, will they get another playoff? Maybe I'm wrong. There we go. 8 seconds, 5-4. Oh no, off to the races. The running back just shot free there. And to end the first quarter, it's Patrick Hall with a 33-yard carry. I thought we had him dead to rights on the run, but he just used that strength and got free. Unfortunately for his team, they're still down two scores as we head into this second quarter. So what is it that we can do to slow these guys down? A couple of big plays here and there. The defense was solid for that first quarter, but they need to keep it up for the rest of the half. And Jenkins gets a big hit there, but we do give up another 5 yards on the ground. Our running game leaving a little bit to be desired so far. So we'll hope that we can just clamp down, get the job done. The pitch out towards the edge. It's Sandcastle of all people just absolutely obliterating Patrick Hall for a loss of 5. Typically, I consider Leon to be the guy that is most likely to get trucked on the team, but he just showed up and dominated that man. Forces the 3rd and 10. They're stepping back, looking to throw. Quarterback's going to have somebody. And there's the catch. Oh, I thought we had that covered. I kind of screwed it up, and they get the first down. Just the second pass of the day now for this quarterback as they will run it up the middle for a loss of 2. Gives us a 2nd and 12 to work with. Again, just trying to slow them down as much as possible. Somebody's got to be open. Jenkins gets there apparently with perfect timing and forces the incompletion. It's 3rd and 12. It's not often that we see plays work that well for us, so I love to see it on 3rd and 12. What will we be thrown? We know they're going to the air. Stepping back, trying to cover it. They throw short. Sandcastle and company are there. It's 4th and 4. We might have held them to a field goal. It's the field goal formation that comes out. We are in the safe zone. But I got to imagine, if you're West Virginia, you have to go for this. 3 points isn't going to do it unless you can slow down our offense, and they haven't showed any signs of doing that so far. So it's 14-3. Our lead still 2 scores, and Marquise gets the chance to do what he does best and return this kick. The blocking is impeccable, and he's off to the races. One man, number 41 to beat, but he's going to do it. No! The incredible shoestring tackle to save the kick return for the touchdown. He catches me celebrating too early. I thought he was gone for sure, but now we have work to do. 19 yards to find pay dirt as we hand it off to Fontaine, and he's got great blocking again. Our offense is absolutely moving today. 2nd and inches inside the 10. We're going to keep going to Mike as he's having a good game so far, and there's our 1st and goal. 3.5 or so minutes left in this first half. Mike Fontaine going to come in motion now. On this jet sweep, the blocking is okay. He breaks a tackle, though, and he finds 6 yards. Every once in a while, his running is so strong. He continues to be phenomenal, and I call the fullback dive, but J.J. Barr's in at running back right now, so we're going to audible this so that we can actually give it to our starting fullback. Purcell goes in motion. The handoff to the fullback. Not quite working. Ran into a guy. Just gets back to the line of scrimmage. Well, let's try this again. Mike is in at running back. JJ's back in the fullback spot. We're going right up the middle. Fullback dive blocking again. Not there. And Barr gets met at the line. It's 4th and goal. I said earlier that we would be taking the points, but we are 2 yards from the end zone. I'd much rather have 7 than 3. So it's going to be the read option. Radon's keeping it. All the space in the world. Completely untouched. As he just walks into the end zone, and we increase the lead once again. That makes it an 18-point lead with 2:11 left in the half, as again, we're going to allow them to return a kick. So far, it's been working pretty well for us, and that trend continues, keeping them inside the 20. At what point do we see the game plan of West Virginia start to change? They've been running the ball a ton. We know that they can pass the ball pretty well, but we haven't seen it yet. Maybe they don't need to. If they can string together a couple more runs, they'll be good, and they take their first time out there. So 2 minutes left in the half. We know that they are conscious of the clock. We're going to try and establish... Oh! Some good pass defense. Spencer Stanley dropped his pick. Would have been his 8th interception of the season, but he can't hold on to it. As it's now 3rd and 3, I'm kind of expecting the run. Try to pinch up the middle here. No, it's a screen. We're not in position. John Taylor, the diving tackle is there, and we'll take the timeout because we just got another stop. So the punt formation back out once again. We keep them inside their own 25-yard line, and we'll have just under 2 minutes to work with. As again, we're going to have great field position, and it could be a whole lot better. Marquise Jackson running towards the sideline. Another diving tackle saves a huge potential return, though. The Mountaineers are playing with fire on these returns, but so far they have not been burned. 1st and 10, will step back, looking to throw. They're bringing maybe a little bit of pressure. This is a tough one, but we got Chad Bradshaw diving for the one-handed catch 21 yards downfield. Got to go in the hurry up after that one. Just 1:40. We don't want to run out of time on the drive as Radon outside the pocket. Maybe has a man. No, it should have been intercepted. Oh, I got lucky there. Well, let's try to catch him off guard. Maybe a little play action. Fake the sweep to Chad. Throw over the middle. We've got Stewart. He's going to truck over a man. It's 1st and goal. Sean with a great catch there. Well, we got him with the play action version. Let's go with the actual jet sweep. Give it to Chad Bradshaw. The blocking is okay. But I tried to turn it up and ran into a blocker, so just stopped at the line. 2 timeouts to work with, 1 minute on the clock. I'm not necessarily worried about the time now that we are inside the 10. We're going to run it on 2nd down, try to get a more manageable 3rd down, but the blocking isn't there, and Mike just ran into a blocker and kind of fell backwards. We lost 5 yards. So it's 3rd and goal from the 13-yard line. My main look is at Marquise on the left there. If he has the one-on-one, I think that's got to be a touchdown. Otherwise, maybe Williams on the other side. 3rd and goal, 30 seconds. He's got the one-on-one. We're throwing it to Marquise. He's wide open in the front corner of the end zone. There's a school record for receiving touchdowns in a season. Radon finds another passing touchdown on the day. With just 30 seconds left in the half, we increase the lead once again. I hate to say it, but at this point, West Virginia is getting absolutely bodied. There is nothing that they can seemingly do to slow down our offense, and our defense is smothering them so far. I know for a fact, 2 timeouts and 20 seconds, what I would be doing in this situation, but I know what West Virginia is going to try to do, and it's going to be run and take a timeout, and now they'll throw up a couple passes. So the question is, can we prevent them from getting the Hail Mary that they want so badly? 19 seconds left. They step back to throw. Quarterback, plenty of time. Throws it up. Sandcastle gets the interception. 14 seconds on the clock. He's running the other way. He picks up a block, and he gets out of bounds with 9 seconds to go. This has been an absolute standout game for Leon. He's showing up in a big way at a big time, and now we have a chance maybe to throw up a couple of quick passes. This one could be it in the end zone. Williams can't come down with it. 4 seconds to go. Well, let's throw up the Hail Mary, I guess. Couple of guys in the area hoping for the best on this one. Heaving it up. It's made it to the end zone, and it just hits the turf. Innocently enough for West Virginia. Oh, it would have been so good if we could have made them pay for that interception, but we still head into the locker rooms with a 28-3 lead. Certainly can't be upset about that. I mean, I don't really have any criticisms for our team. We've played phenomenally. Maybe I've made a couple of plays that weren't so great, but the team itself has been superb. I mean, even if we just hold West Virginia to a couple touchdowns in the 2nd half and don't score, we have a big enough lead. We should be able to win this. So not much to say. Let's just get this 3rd quarter kicked off. as Marquise is back here ready to return, I gotta ask you right now to go on down and hit the like button. Helps get this video seen by a whole lot more people, and maybe Marquise can do something for you. Decent return, we'll take that. We'll try to get back to the running game a little bit at the start of this quarter. Always feel like at the end of the half when I start passing a ton, it's hard for me to transition back to the run at the start. So try to remind the defense that that's still a capability for us. Lost a yard on that first attempt as we will go with the read option. The inverted veer on this one. Radon's going to keep it. He's got a little bit of space. Oh, so close to completely breaking free downfield. Doesn't quite get there though, and it's now a third and two as I will step back looking to throw and waiting over the middle, trying to find someone. It's picked off. That was a terrible throw from me right into the linebacker's hands, and that's going to be a pick six unless Williams can get there. So the first touchdown for West Virginia comes from the defense. A terrible decision for me, and kind of feels like I'm throwing. We gotta bounce right back, get this ball back, and drive down the field and score. Certainly not what you like to see. Well, we'll hope for the best. Marquise is a little bit tired, so he won't be returning this kick. It's Aaron Jenkins, and it's not a great return. I'm gonna say unsurprisingly on that one, we just get it to the 20. All the momentum now sits with West Virginia. What can the offense do? Just threw a pick six. They got to bounce back quick. And Mike Fontaine with a great carry. Cuts it back, finds the space, and gets 8 yards. I certainly don't mind passing the ball, but we'll get it out of Radon's hands for a couple of plays in a row and try to pick up a first down just on the ground here. And this is an incredibly dangerous play. Typically, draw plays do not work for me, but we're going with the QB draw. And Radon has the space for it to work, and he gets the first down in the third down conversion. So with that play, we allow Radon to take control of the play. We get the ball in his hands, but we don't force him to pass. And now we will allow him to pass, see if we can find somebody open. Go with the quick check down to Marquise and get 8 more yards as we approach midfield. The best news for us in this situation is that while we did give up the points to West Virginia, the clock is going to be ticking this entire drive. With the 6-minute quarters, West Virginia already has to be worried about how much time is left in the game. Stepping back once again to throw. They are bringing 4 guys on the rush, and they've left us way too much space just to scramble. I wanted to pass there, but I'm still a little gun shy right now. At the midway point in this third quarter, we'll hand the ball off again. Giving it to Mike, trying to stretch towards the edge, and somehow he finds some space out there. I thought it was going to be a loss of yards, but he ends up getting 3. Hoping to be a little bit dangerous on this one. The play action, 2nd and 7, pressure coming off the edge. Got to get rid of it, and Radon, I don't know how they count that as a pass, but just kind of flipped it over his shoulder. The refs call the incompletion, and we get to keep our field position and get this 3rd and 7 attempt. Hoping for the best. They're pressed up on Jackson. Typically, that looks really good for us. We'll get outside the pocket, and Marquise might have been open, but this is not going to work out. Yeah, Radon didn't have the speed, and at that point, once I committed to the run, there was nobody to pass to. So it's 4th and 7, and I got to go for this. I don't think that we're in Frederick's range for the field goal. This drive has not gone to plan so far. In fact, this quarter has not gone to plan. 4th and 7, stepping back, looking to throw outside the pocket, and we're going to get sacked for a loss of 12. What am I doing? Oh my goodness. Well, we got to figure this out in a hurry. Hopefully the defense still has their wits about them as they will throw a screen on first down. That worked tremendously well. Casey Smith finds 13 yards. Another first down for these guys. This one's going to be a run. He cuts it back up the middle, and again, tons of space. We're starting to fall apart here. I got to bring at least a little bit of a blitz, I think, but just doesn't feel right. 2nd and inches. I'm expecting them to run the ball, but the quarterback's not set. This might be a glitch, and it might be a delay of game that completely bails us out. Well, typically I would just abuse this glitch and take the free 5 yards backwards, but we're just going to come out and get an encroachment and allow them to get those 5 yards back. Try to keep it fair here. Or I guess we could just decline the penalty. That's also an option. Radon Randell, strained pectoral, out for a quarter, so we're going to have the backup quarterback in. Next time we take the field, that's not good. He's been taking a lot of hits. Certainly don't like that. Trying to bring pressure. Quarterback throws it away on second and inches. We get them to this third down. And we are going to sub in David Williams. He's 94 overall. He should be able to get the job done for a quarter. The last thing that we need to do is have that injury be aggravated as... they've come out five wide. Can we audible in time? Quarterback stepping back. He's going to try to scramble all the space in the world. Can we strip the ball? No. It's a 9-yard scramble and they get the first down. I wanted to bring the blitz, but not against a five wide set. So instead we just have to settle for being in the zone. It doesn't work for us. Quarterback again scrambles. This time gets 4 yards. Worst news for this quarterback is he's taking hits as... we are going to bring a little bit of a safety blitz on second and six. This could be a sweep. Kind of expecting it to be that way. No, quarterback decided to keep it. I don't know if that was designed or the play broke, but they lose 6 yards. It's third and 13. This could be the final play of this third quarter. We'll see. I'm expecting the pass. They will step back looking to throw. Man's open. And he's not going to get the first down. Fourth and inches. I got to think they go for this, though. Well, I'm taking a risk. I'm coming out in the goal line set because a turnover on downs here would be absolutely huge. But we're going to have to wait a little chance for our off or for their offense to rest and for our defense to rest. That was a bad quarter for us. We lose 7 points on our lead. We throw that pick six and they are knocking on the door once again. We still are up 18, so got to feel confident heading into this fourth. We got to take this momentum away from on fourth and inches. It's the option out towards the edge. Don Riley misses the tackle, and it's a first and goal at the one. He should have had this stop, but he couldn't get there. A great opportunity for West Virginia to cut this score early in the fourth quarter now. They'll step back to throw, but the blitz gets there, and we get the sack for a loss of four. A little bit of breathing room now for the defense. As we'll see them step back to pass again. Quarterback scrambling somehow finds a gap up the middle and waltzes into the end zone for the touchdown. That is disappointing. They'll go for two to try to make this a 10-point game. 5.5 minutes left in the game. What can we do? They step back to throw. Quarterback has a man over the middle. I couldn't get there in time, so it's completed. It is 28-18. No onside kicks just yet. I'm getting a little bit worried. Marquise back to return. Could he do enough for us? That's a good return up the middle. Kind of rare for us. Gives us decent field position. David Williams comes in for his first snap at quarterback. We're going to go with the draw. He is technically a better passer than Radon, so we have something to work with. We just got to remember we can't really run with him. The draw works well for a gain of 8 on first down. We'll go play action on this one, although they're bringing pressure, and we get sacked. Mike Fontaine tripped us up. We fell backwards, and we lost all our yards. It's 3rd and 10. We're choking, but Radon has come back in. I guess he said he was feeling fine, so we'll have an opportunity to pick this up with our starting quarterback at the helm. Looking for it. Oh, no, I threw a bad one. Mike Fontaine comes down with it. The DB overran the route, but it's still 4th and 1. They went for the interception and missed it, which is good because it would have been a pick six. But now we have to punt the ball away. And I don't like this. I'm going to let every second burn off the clock here. I'm getting a little bit worried about how strong the Mountaineers have looked so far in this second half. A fieldable kick at the 20. They're going to get a decent return out to the 30. And they've got 3:43 to work with, down 10. If we blow a 28-3 lead, I'm going to lose my mind. 1st and 10, West Virginia gets this drive underway with a little draw play. Big tackle from Don Riley, but they get 6 yards out of it. Hoping that they go to the air. It's a run up the middle on that one. We stop them, though. It's 3rd and 5. West Virginia is in this hurry up, knowing that time is not on their side. Midway point now in the third quarter is upon us. Quarterback just trucked a hit to get almost the first down. It's 4th and inches. I got to imagine they go for it. We can't stack up the line, though, and try to bring a big blitz because they could just run this. Fourth and inches, quarterback throwing it up. Sandcastle, oh my gosh, that's on me. Oh, that should have been the easiest stop of our lives. I tried to switch to him to make sure we got the pick, and I just accidentally moved him out of the way. So it's a first and 10. They step back to throw again. This one, Spencer Stanley drops his second pick of the game. Our defensive backs are playing a million times better than we expect them to, but it's me and my user that's absolutely killing our defense so far today. Another second and 10. They step back to throw. Quarterback's going to scramble. Sandcastle slows him down, but this scramble's working way too well for John Hunter. Expecting a run on this third and one. Guy goes in motion. No, they step back to throw. Quarterback has a man wide open. They go to the check down to the running back, and it's another first down. I'm starting to sweat a little bit, getting nervous about the way this is going, but we just got bailed out there. Oh, the false start will back him up 5 yards and give us a chance to breathe. 2:10 on the clock now. Still a 10-point game. Expecting them to step back. There it is. No, the strip sack means you got to get that. He picks it up. No space to run. I was paying attention to my assignment. I didn't see Thomas break free there. And just absolutely drill the quarterback. That's got to be game. 2:03 on the clock. We're going to win the turnover battle so far, unless we make a big mistake here. But we can start forcing the Mountaineers to take their timeouts. Of course, we do have to get a first down here. Second and 9. Obviously handing it off to Mike Fontaine, and he's got nowhere to go once again. It's 3rd and 8. 2 timeouts down, though, for the Mountaineers. Even if we just go 3 and out here, it's a chance for us to burn a couple of seconds off the clock and make it that much more difficult for West Virginia. They're bringing a lot of pressure as we step back to throw. Throwing a tough one. Sean Stewart, the tight end, comes down with it. That's going to be the final timeout for West Virginia, as we have gotten to midfield with 1:53. Just got to hold on to the football now. Mike Fontaine breaks a tackle and gets 5 yards. And we're going to give it to him again here on 2nd and 5. Just over 1 minute to play. It looks like we are about to punch our ticket into that national championship game. And with that first down, we can just come out with Raid on and take the knee. And that's going to be it. Oh, my goodness. We will let the clock run out here in the Orange Bowl as we come away with the victory, 28-18. We didn't score a point in that second half, kind of like I predicted, but the defense did enough and the offense was able to keep the drives alive long enough to start burning the clock. So we are into that national championship game. The question is, will we be playing Oklahoma, or will it be a rematch of the SEC championship game against Tennessee? Man, if we play like we did in the first half, we dominate, we win the national championship. If we play like we did in the second half, we might be a little bit disappointed in that next game. Well, that was an interesting game for sure. 28-18. We only gave up one offensive touchdown to West Virginia, so our defense did, all things considered, a very good job. 145 rushing, 125 passing for us, compared to their 126 and 89 passing. The fact that we held the team to that little through the air is fantastic. We win the turnover battle, and we killed them on time of possession. Radon is obviously our offensive player of the game. 9 of 16 for 125 yards. 3 total touchdowns. He had some nice runs. The interception was not great, and it gave them a chance to come back into the game. But other than that, he did a very good job. Craig Thomas, our left end, though, the sack, the forced fumble, absolutely won the game at the end there. So that's fantastic. So we have won the Orange Bowl now. Go ahead and add that. And now we got to figure out who it is that we're playing. Will it be Oklahoma, or will it be Tennessee in the Cotton Bowl? Go ahead and sim it. Who's coming away with the win? We are, oh my gosh, it's an overtime victory for the Sooners. So we will be playing Oklahoma in the national championship game. So let's go ahead and establish that. We will go to our third step of the playoff. We will load our file in, and we will just let it load in, and I am ready for this. We're playing at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara, so fans of both teams having to travel a long way for this game, but I am ready for it. Very excited that we get a chance to end our tenure with the Teal Boys in the national championship game. Oklahoma should be a solid team to play against, and we'll have the chance to beat a team that's been in the news a lot. Maybe they're trying to join our conference. So we'll go ahead and save that one. And while it's saving, maybe again, just like at halftime, if you didn't do it then, now's a great chance to go down and hit that like button. We can load back in here to the Dynasty, and there it is. Number one versus number three, Oklahoma. We finally can see a matchup. We are not favored to win this game. We're 15-0. They're 12-2. They are 99 overall team across the board. They have dominated on offense. Their defense has been very, very solid. They're stopping the pass pretty easily so far this season, but they do also have two losses. They lost to a 7-5 Texas, and they lost to a 7-5 Kansas State. So that certainly makes me feel a little bit more confident, but you just never know. Unfortunately, that's going to have to do it for this episode. Again, if you like the video, please hit the like button. It helps the video be seen by a ton more people. And if you want to be notified for when these videos get posted, hopefully more frequently, but with the move, we'll see. Go ahead and go down and subscribe as well. While you're down there, you can head to the description where you will find links to my Twitch at twitch.tv/goonmaster. There's also links to my Twitter, our community Discord, and as always, the College Football Revamped mod if you're trying to get that for yourself. All that being said, though, thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Goonmaster. You guys are the Teal Boys, wherever you are. Have a good night or have a good morning. We'll see you later. Adios.